The extreme value theorem is a theorem that will guarantee us an absolute max or min for a function if a few certain conditions happen to be met. So here's what it says. It says the extreme value theorem guarantees us an absolute max and a minimum if, number one, the function's defined on a closed interval, and number two, the function's continuous. So if those two criteria are met, then I know that there has to be an absolute maximum and a minimum. And we can kind of tell why just based off of this picture I've drawn here. Here I've got the function defined on a closed interval, and really what this is saying in a subtle way, kind of behind the scenes, is that the function will be defined on its endpoints. Because remember, absolute maxes and mins could be defined at their left or right endpoint. And that's what number one is guaranteeing, is that I'm not saying that they will be the max or min, but I'm saying they still have the opportunity. There's no open dots or open circles at the endpoints because it's defined on the closed interval. And number two, the function's continuous on that closed interval. So there's no asymptotes, there's no holes where it jumps or anything like that, which is another place where we can lose absolute maxes and mins. So here we go. We got it defined on a closed interval from A to B. And if I draw from the point at A to the point at B without picking my pencil up, then it'll achieve just a consistent number of y values along the way. It'll go up and it'll go down and back up or do whatever it's going to do, but without any jumps or holes or asymptotes or anything like that, then it's pretty clear there will be a highest y value and there will be a lowest y value. Now here's a couple examples. Now we're not going to do much with these other than just see if the extreme value theorem can be applied. Right here I have y equals 1 over x minus 2, which right off the bat makes me a little nervous because that guy is not continuous everywhere. It has an asymptote. Now let's see here though. Where would that asymptote be? That it would have a vertical asymptote at x equals 2, but notice that's not within my interval from 3 to 7. So here I would say the absolute max and min is guaranteed by the extreme value theorem. It is guaranteed, it's promised to me, because it's continuous on that interval and it's defined on a closed interval from 3 to 7. So there is an absolute maximum and a minimum for 1 over x minus 2 in that interval. Now the other function is y equals tan x on the interval from minus pi to pi. Now, one thing we know about tangent is you could write it as sine x over cosine x. Now, again, that makes me a little concerned because of this cosine function here. If we took cosine x and set it equal to 0, we would notice that this has solutions. If you think about your unit circle, cosine is 0 at pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2 and 5 pi over 2, et cetera, lots of different values within this interval. So even though it's defined on a closed interval, it's not guaranteed to have an absolute max or min by the extreme value theorem. So the absolute max and min is not guaranteed by the extreme value theorem. Now, when you run into a situation where absolute max and min is not guaranteed by the extreme value theorem, that's not specifically saying that it won't have an absolute max or min. It's just saying that the extreme value theorem can't promise it to you. It can't guarantee you that max or min. When these two conditions are met, the extreme value theorem is very helpful in rock solidly proving that there has to be a max or min on that closed interval.